life and how to create it, how to make it.
It's positively scathing about our preoccupation with matter itself. We have this tendency to think that only solid material things are really things at all. Waves of electromagnetic fluctuation in a vacuum seem unreal. Victorians thought that waves had to be waves in some kind of material medium, the ether. But we find real matter comforting only because we have learned to survive in middle world, where matter is a useful fiction. A whirlpool, to Steve Grant, this author, is a thing with just as much reality as a rock. In a desert plain in Tanzania, in the shadow of the volcano Oldoinyo Lengai, there is a dune made of volcanic ash. The beautiful thing is that it moves bodily. It is what is technically known as a barkan, a walking dune. The entire dune walks across the desert in a westerly direction at a speed of about 17 meters per year. It retains its crescent shape and moves in the direction of the horns. What happens is that the wind blows the sand up the shallow slope on the other side, and then as each sand grain hits the top of the ridge, it cascades down on the inside of the crescent. And so the whole horn-shaped dune moves. Steve Grant points out that you and I, ourselves, are more like a wave than a permanent thing. He invites you, the reader in this case, to think of an experience from your childhood, something you remember clearly, something that you can see, feel, or maybe even smell, as if you were really there. After all, you were really there at that time, weren't you? How else would you remember it? But here is the bombshell. Not a single atom that is in your body today was there when that event took place. Matter flows from place to place and momentarily comes together to be you. So whatever you are, therefore, you are not the stuff of which you are made. And if that doesn't make the hair stand up on the back of your neck, think of it again, because it is important.
Thank you.